as one climb finishes and another one is about to start, welcome to today's Swift Garmin tip, which isn't about Garmin head units, it's about Garmin Verb Edit and how to resurrect it from the dead. Now, quick backstory on this one, I used to use Garmin Verb Edit quite a lot to the overlays that you're seeing here on the screen, in particular the elevation profile for the route that I'm on right now. And it was really, really handy as these things start climbing away here. However, Verb Edit was designed for Garmin Verb cameras, Verb Action cameras, which I think have been unsupported for a very long time. So the software hasn't been updated from, if memory serves me right, since 2018. Now, over time, it's been left to quietly die away. I can no longer get it working on the Apple Mac, on the M1 or the M1 Max. Windows, since switching to the Edge browser and retiring Internet Explorer, the software has no longer worked. However, some genius over on Reddit published a little registry entry that you can do via a command line to resurrect Garmin Verb Edit on Windows, Windows 11, from the dead. Now, I'll put links in the video description below to this, but let's quickly jump back to the Llama Lab and show you what happens before this fix and how easy the fix is to do and how it works after the fix.
Okay, so here's the error that you'll get without the fix in place. You've got to import the geometrics and you'll get a script error as it tries to show you where on the map things were overlaid to. Not a good sign. Okay, then simply whacking this command in to an administrative command line. Again, details in the video description of how to do all this. Loading up Verb Edit again, clicking on the geometric sync, and there we have it. The map overlay works. We can line things up and use this, as we always have, to build our on-screen overlays and do whatever we need to do. But the most important part is to line up these geometrics if the information isn't in the video file itself. Now, this isn't because I'm using the GoPro Hero 11 Mini, which doesn't have GPS.
All right, simple as that. As I said, links in the video description below. This will get Verb Edit up and running again for Windows if you want to do some really, really simple overlays from a FIT file and any compatible video file. I've never owned, never used, never had any footage from a Garmin Verb camera. I've always used my GoPros for this and FIT files from any head unit. And it has worked brilliantly. So this won't work forever. I suspect the software will soon die completely. But for now, if you're looking at doing some overlays and you want to jump back to do Verb Edit stuff, it's now available and also allows me to do cool things as you're seeing here on screen to show all the hills that are coming up and where they are being detected by both Garmin Climb Pro Freeride and the still in beta version of the Wahoo Summit Freeride. And those playing the long game with the channel, you may recognize it. This is the climb that started my whole what the hell's going on with Climb Pro problems, because it's a real steep little section coming up that it was like 300 meters off. Anyhow, that's for another day. This video was all about how to get Verb Edit working again. Sorry, my English isn't that great when I'm trying to climb hills. But that'll get it up and running for a little while now. I'd love to see Garmin just sort of give it a bit of love, update it, allow us to use it for other things. It's a great bit of software. But for now, that's the finish of this part of the video. And to keep YouTube happy, I'll now play the rest of my ride for the next 40 minutes or so. Enjoy, come along for the ride and we'll see you at the end. Nah. I'll hike a bike this one. Okay, so if you're wondering what the Garmin's up to, that's a display bug in the X40 firmware. If I scroll across and back, it's fine. One for Garmin support. You can see both climbs are a little bit different of how they've detected. So Garmin's up and around the corner. The Wahoo's like, nah, nah, you're good at the next road. Come on, Maya, you could have counted that as one climb. So here's the Bermuda Triangle, and it dips down and up, but neither unit really showed that on the profile. Definitely not negative 2%. I think about 8 or 9. 7. All right. 8, there we go. Welcome to the party. 9. Still a few metres to climb. Plus or minus 50, I think, is the average of where these hit things right. Right turn, let's go. The look ahead elevation on the Bolt 2 is pretty accurate. It's a roller coaster. This is where the Wahoo implementation comes in very, very handy. And down we go. It's custom alert notifications on the Wahoo. So the Garmin started very early on that and has gone across the main road, which is actually where I'm riding. Wahoo wasn't as confident. Now it will be interesting to see if the Wahoo does pick up the short, sharp climb across the road here. Kudos to Garmin for picking that one up though. That's a good get. Left or right here on the main road is obviously the most popular, but straight ahead, which is where I'm heading, is up, up, up. The Wahoo hasn't picked it up, but with the reader head we can see it pinches up and then we have a nice downhill. I need some better tunes. Hey Siri, play Wolf Alice Smile. Oh, I'm out of data range. Yeah, I'm out of data. Well, there's proof that this functionality works without a data connection. All right, fun begins now. Well, the fun began about 52 k's ago, actually. Alright, can we crack 60 k's an hour on the dirt? Let's see. It's a bit rough through here. Oh, Jesus. Alright, 60 k's. Let's go, let's go. Come on. Let's get up. There we go, 64. Lovely. Hyper smooth working overtime on the GoPro along here. It's pretty rough. All right, in about a kilometre's time or so is my sprint point on the gravel. A slight rise before dropping back into town. All right, around the corner, sprint point. 2 pound meters on the bike today, so doing multiple things here. Let's go. Rear wheel traction is the hardest thing to get here. All right. There we go. Alrighty, thanks for coming along for the ride, if you join me on that one. And that's a wrap on today's video, resurrecting Garmin Verb Edit from the dead and giving it a little bit more life for us to put things in videos like you've seen here today. Alright, as always, give this one a thumbs up to help the algorithm. Hit subscribe to be alerted of new videos on this channel. You know what it's all about. Do the YouTube stuff and everyone's happy. Alright, enjoy your next ride, guys.